Hi there. In the last couple of videos, we looked at how to create simple motion paths and how to use triggers to connect them to learner action. Let's take a look at this slide and see where we're at. Okay. So I've got my heart here on the stairs, and if I click the move up button, then the heart will animate from the start point along the curve to the end point. And if I reset the slide, I could click the down button, and the heart will animate from the start point to the end point along the curve. Now that's how a motion path works by default. You always start at the start point and you animate through to the end point. So if I click the down button again, it returns to the start point and animates again. Now, maybe what we would like to happen here is to have the heart animate up and down all of the stairs and not always return to the start point. Luckily, this is really easy in Storyline 2. All you do is select the motion path, and you look here under Path Options, and at the bottom is Relative Start Point. And if I tick that on, like that, then instead of returning to the start point and animating again along the same curve, the start point's going to move with the shape as the shape animates. Now, I'll enable that for both of these motion paths. Turn it on for this one too. And now when we preview this slide, when I click the up button, it'll go up. And if I click it again, it goes up again. If I click it again, it goes up again. And of course I can go down and down and up and down. This is really great, isn't it? We really love motion paths here. I'm super excited about this feature. Enjoy.